Long ago, sages used to know what is happening in the world sitting at a place. Now even we are able to do so sitting at a place using our phones. We used to read books which says, due to limited resources, there would be a single phone which is used by everyone in a village to talk to their friends and families who are in other villages. That is represented here in orange line. Later, we had enough resources and technology in place to serve each individual with a mobile. That is the blue line. And the green line here represents things communicating to each other over the internet, and this is called Internet of Things. If we want to deep dive into a technology, we have to understand what is the technology, how it has come into existence, where and why it is used, and when and for whom it is developed. So let's have a look at what happened in 1982. Back then, there were four students who felt lazy to go to the canteen and check whether the Cokes are available and are they cool enough or not. So they have developed a small circuit with sensors and embedded it into the Coke machine so that they get the Coke information to their classroom desk itself. Here, humans are getting the data from things. Good or bad, to overcome their laziness, those students had developed a solution, and we all are discussing that as a technology in this generation. Also, there is another incident that happened in 1989. An employee developed a system where he can on the switch connected to the bread toaster while he was on the way to the home from office so that he can have a quick dinner as he reaches the home. Here, humans are sending the data to things. So from the above two scenarios, we can understand that things can send the data to humans and also humans can send the data to things over the internet. This was presented in 1999 by Kevin Hashton, who is father of IoT. But IoT is not the same as it was. Let's take an example of IoT, how it has evolved. To wake up early in the morning, we set an alarm. As we wake up, we turn off the alarm, which turns on the geyser. As we take the bath and get ready, our geyser would notify the kitchen appliances and keep the breakfast ready. And as the next step is to go to office, car garage is also open. Here, things communicate to things and make daily tasks easy for us. Here, we are eliminating human to avoid human errors. But this is not a good example for IoT anymore. Let's take an example on similar lines. If you forgot to set the alarm, it will automatically set itself, taking information from the calendar. Also, it checks the traffic and updates the alarm to reach our destination without any delay. So here, we can see things getting intelligent and also having decision-making capability. Also, let's see the future of IoT. In a family, there are father, mother, and a son. One day, the father observes his wife washing the clothes manually. So he buys a new washing machine to make her life easy. They have been using it for a while and suddenly the washing machine stops working. Mother is unable to figure out the issue. She waits for her son to return from school. As soon as the son is back home, she asks to have a look at the washing machine. As everyone, son also feels like an engineer and tries to on off the washing machine. But all his attempts fail. Son calls the customer care and as per instructions on the call, they try to fix it. But again, he fails. So the customer care will say that they would allocate a technician in 4 to 5 working days. So a technician visits the house and checks for the problem. He identifies that a part needs to be exchanged. He informs he has to order and he will get back with the part in 4 to 5 working days. Finally, technician fixes the washing machine. It completely took 2 to 3 weeks for the repair. So in these days, mother actually followed the old process of washing the clothes. As there was a gap, it was more difficult to her. But actually, the washing machine was bought to reduce mother's hardship. So imagine if there are sensors installed in the washing machine, it would alert mother when it is overloaded with clothes or has insufficient water. Also, if there is any part going to be damaged, it alerts the manufacturer to replace the part. So the machine can provide continuous service. This is called predictive analytics, through which the health of the things are tracked. IoT could be more advanced using IoE and 5G. There are smart homes, smart health, smart cities, and many more domains where IoT can be used. Technically, things are installed with sensors. These sensors send the data to the gateway through SIM cards and Wi-Fi. The gateway sends the data to cloud with APIs and stores the data in cloud. Also, rule engines are available to write conditions and extract useful data to generate alerts and also make reports on the performance of things. So expecting that the video explained the basics of IoT, For any doubts or support in the product development, feel free to contact me through WhatsApp or mail. And for more information on IoT and other technologies, subscribe to my channel. Thank you.